French immigration to the Cape. In 1688, about 200 French-speaking immigrants arrived at the Cape. These immigrants were Protestants called Huguenots. They were forced to leave their homeland because the Catholic King Louis prohibited them from practicing their Protestant faith in France. Huguenots fled to the Protestant countries in Europe. Some of the Huguenots who went to the Netherlands were sent to the Cape. At the Cape, the Huguenots were given farms near the Beg River in the Franschhoek Valley. In France, they had worked at skilled jobs like being wagon makers and farmers. Now, looking at expanding European frontiers. During the 1700s, the colony at the Cape consisted of two groups, slaves and free citizens. There were more slaves than free people in the colony throughout the 18th century. There were a few freed slaves, and they were called free blacks. The Khoi were not considered citizens of the colony. The colony slowly grew to the east and to the north. In 1777, Colonel Robert Gordon, commander of the VOC soldiers at the Cape, traveled as fast east as the river where he met Xhosa chiefs. In 1778, Gordon traveled to the north east frontier area colony. He traveled together with the governor of the Cape at the time, Van Plettenberg. During this journey, they reached the Gariep River and named it the Orange River, in honor of the ruler of Netherlands, Prince William of Orange. Gordon kept journals and drew pictures of what he saw on his travels. Now let's continue to look at the movement of trekboers with their slaves and servants inland. In the 1700s, the VOC got the wheat and wine they needed from the free burgers, farmers in and around the Cape. The VOC needed livestock farmers to supply meat. Stock farmers were encouraged to move inland, moving north and east from Western Cape. These livestock farmers were allowed to establish huge farms. The farmers moved around to find the best grazing for their sheep and cattle, often leaving their farms for months at a time. They became trekboers, which means farmers who trekked or moved. Trekboers also became hunters and traded with the Khoi. Livestock and stories of trekboers. Trekboers had a particular lifestyle. They traveled with their slaves and servants in ox wagons. They had horses and guns. They lived in their wagons or in tents. They hunted wild animals for meat. They got milk and wheat from their sheep. They visited towns from time to time to get the supplies that they could not provide themselves, like coffee and gunpowder for their guns. And also, they boiled a fat from the fat-tailed sheep with wood ash to make soap.